Hello students, today in our e-lecture we will discuss the questions of brain teasers of chapter 3. Convert the given rational number into decimal. This rational number is given to us and we have to convert this rational number into decimal. I am going to choose the long division method. Now first 1, then 15 is smaller than 80, 157. 80 ones are 80. 7 minus 0, 7. 15 minus 8, 7. 3. 80 nines are 720. 3, 5. The next digit will come 535. 18 six are 480. 5, 5. Now there is no digit in the number and 55 is not divisible by 80, so we'll start with the decimal 0. 550 again 80, 6 are 480. 0, 15 minus 8, 7, 1 0 will come. 88 are 640. 0, 10 minus 4, 6, 100. 87 are 50, 560. Then 0, 10 minus 6, 4, 400, 85 are 400. Now this rational number is equal to, the decimal representation of this rational number is equal to 196.6875. And denominator is 0. We are getting a definite number of digits in the quotient. So this rational number has a terminating decimal form. Next example, find the decimal representation of the number minus 12 by 30. Second example I am taking. Decimal representation, divide the numerator with the denominator. 12 is not divisible by 13, so we will start with the decimal 120. 39s are 117. 30, 10 will come automatically. 30. 13 2s are 26, 4, 0, 40, 13 3s are 39, 1, 1, 0 will come. But again the 10 is not divisible by 13, 10 is smaller than 13. So we need one more 0 here. So we are going to place 0 in the quotient. Then 13 7s are 91, 90. 13 6 are 78. 2, 1, 120, 13, 9s are 117, 30. Now what we observe? The digit starts repeating here. 120, then 30, 40, 100, 90. The remainder will never become 0 because the digit in the quotient start repeating. So the decimal representation of this rational number is 0.923076. And I'm going to place the bar over all these three digits which are keep on repeating. Moving to the next question, simplify the given expression. In this expression, we are having the addition and the subtraction of decimal number. So we will follow Bodmer's rule. Now we are having two positive number, 13.20 and 0.02. And two negative number, minus 5.7, minus 15.009. So I am going to add the positive numbers, 13.20 and 0.02 will become 13.22. Minus 5.7, minus 15.009. Both are negative number, just to add and put negative sign, that will become 9072070.709. Now we are left with a positive number and a negative number, which we have already discussed. Subtract the smaller number from the bigger number and place the sign of the bigger number. So we are going to subtract 13.22 from 20.70998 47, and the answer is minus 7.489. Moving to the next question, without actual division, we are not going to use the long division method. Without actual division, tell 1 1276 upon 680 has a terminating or non-terminating decimal form. Terminating or non-terminating decimal form. Which rational number is given to us? For this, we must ensure that the given rational number in the standard form. It means both the numbers in the numerator and the denominator should not be divisible by any other number except 1. But both are divisible by 2. 2 6 are 12. 2 3 are 6. 2 8 are 16. 340. Again, both the numbers are divisible by 2. 319. 170. Now, this rational number is in the standard form. Now we are going to find the prime factorization of the denominator. 170 divisible by 2. 85 is divisible by 5. 17. Now we know that if all the prime factors are either 2, either 5 or 2 or 5, only in that case this is a terminating decimal form. But in this prime factorization we have a number 17 other than 2 and 5. So the prime factors are 2, 5 and 17. Therefore, it has non-terminating decimal form. Non-terminating decimal form. So, home assignment for today. Do question number 2 to 5, brain teaser of chapter 3. 2 to 5.